Hello, Mr. Gazda here. Today we're going to do radioactive decay. Carbon 14, carbon dating. This is the example we're going to use, though it applies for all radioactive dating. Watch this. So, a few things. Carbon 14 is a type of carbon that occurs naturally in, let's say, for instance, trees or any natural thing that has carbon in it. And the one thing that's unique about this unstable isotope, carbon 14 will decay naturally, become and turn into nitrogen 14. Okay? This is called the parent, this is called the daughter. It will naturally become nitrogen 14. And the time it takes for that to happen is very set, it doesn't change. For carbon 14, the half-life is the word we use for it, is 5,700 years half-life. I'm going to describe what half-life or how that works right now. I'm going to use blue paper. So in this case, what I'm going to do is I'm going to say the blue paper represents carbon 14. So this is right at the, I'm going to write this in. The blue is carbon 14 in our example, and then the white, you'll see in a second, the white is the nitrogen 14. Okay, so here we go. So you start out, and I'm going to say that at 0 years, right when that tree is growing, what you have is all carbon 14, no nitrogen 14. So I will put down, 0 years have gone by, and zero half lives have gone by. Okay? After one half life has gone by, what happens? Half of the carbon 14, the blue, will decay and become nitrogen 14, and it will look like that. Okay? So that's one half-life has gone by. So that would be 5,700 years of time have passed. And one half-life. Okay? Another half-life goes by. So half of the carbon 14, the blue you have here, will become nitrogen 14. That will stay nitrogen 14 forever. It's stable. So it will look like that. And now we're talking another 5,700 years. So this is the total time here that we're representing is 11,400 years, and then that's two half-lives have passed. Okay, let's do a third. As you can see, hope you can see this pattern here. Okay, half, and then half of this. So that after the third half-life has passed, okay, it is now going, half of this decays to white and looks like this. So this is now three half-lives have passed. And in this case, three half-lives times your half-life, it, of that is going to be, I think it's 17,100 years of time. All right, want to do another one? Do one more half-life? We will. Here we go. Another one will look like this. Okay, again, half of that looks like this. And then the last four half-lives, five half-lives gone by, and that will continue. All right, but that rate is constant, 5,700 years. And that will continue on until you will never get rid of the carbon 14. There will always be some left, but it will get to a point down the road. I think they're usually like 50, 60,000 years is kind of too old. Anything older than that, you can't use carbon 14 to date it because there's just so little of it left. It's very hard to measure. So hopefully this helps. This is a difficult concept for students often to grasp, but I hope this helps. I'm Mr. Gazda. Thanks for watching.